Hey guys, welcome to another episode of How Not to Do Car Audio, and we have this Infiniti in the shop. And the customer came by our shop and they decided that, you know, this isn't for me. I'd rather pay you guys to do it. As you can see here that they were attempting to do a head unit install. You can see one of the connectors over here and that we have these wires cut. I always stress to you guys, buy the proper harnessing. They tried to purchase the harnessing from us, but it was a little bit too complicated. It's okay, because, like, you know, if you don't do this every day, it can be complicated. So some people say, like, oh, head unit installs are easy. Like, well, if you do it a lot, sure. But there's a couple things that you have to consider when you were doing these kind of head unit installs on an Infiniti or a Nissan. The first thing we have to consider is it a factory amplified system? And in this case, it is. So on these Nissans or Infinitis, you actually have to gain the volume. So we set up to 3/4 before we unplug it, gaining the amplifier correctly. That way we get proper volume control from the vehicle. Right now we are extending all the factory wires and we are soldering, shrink tubing everything, and then we can go ahead and finish off with Tesla tape. For this install, we are going to use a module, and what this does is we're going to take the speaker or the high level signal from our aftermarket head unit. It's going to step it down properly. That way, when we send the signal over to the Bose amplifier, it is going to give us proper control. We're not going to get all these weird popping sounds, or when you go from volume 0 to volume 8, it just gets super loud. Also, on these particular vehicles, we also have to run our own ground. So we are attached over here. You can see we have a pigtail, and then we just ground this to chassis. This allows the head unit to be wired properly. You see here, we have now Tesla taped over everything. Now, the thing about Tesla tape is, it's great that it's tough, it doesn't want to chafe, or if it does chafe, it's very hard for it to tear. The downside to it, though, is it doesn't really have good insulating properties. That's why we put shrink tube on top or vinyl tape. So this is just designed to harness your wires together. Also, over here, the plugs were damaged from the previous install, so we put a zap strap over it, or a zip tie, if you'd like to call it that. And this makes sure that the plug doesn't come undone over time. And then here is the rest of our module. Our new head unit is in. You can see we have good volume control, so. So when we max it out, it's just a nice gradual volume control that we have. Now keep in mind, when you see these numbers, some people think like, oh, well, at 10, my factory head unit or this other brand of head unit I had was louder. You have to keep in mind, it depends on how you're interfacing with the factory sound system, whether it has an amplifier or not. It also depends on the brand of deck, because these numbers are not a standard unit of measurement. So 25 on a Pioneer is gonna be very different than 25 on an Alpine. So you see with our new head unit in here, we have a nice seamless look. Different headings allow you to change color. This particular one doesn't, but we have front USB on it. We have Bluetooth as well, so we do hands-free calling. So we have a lot of up-to-date features that newer vehicles have just by switching up the head unit. If you like today's content, make sure to check out my channel and hit the subscribe button, and make sure to hit that bell notification. What that does is it makes sure that you're always kept up to date with all the content that we're providing with you guys on YouTube. So the way that we have the channel set up is I have the uploads up top. That way at all times you can always see, if you just hop by the channel, what our latest upload is. Plus with the bell notification, you're going to get some sort of message from YouTube itself. We also have popular uploads, car videos, how-to videos, demonstration and informational videos, and a lot of cool other specific car videos like our builds playlist. I really like the builds playlist because it takes all the theories from our how-to section and it keeps applying it to different vehicles.